the new Health and Pacific Peoples Minister getting sworn in and taking a moment to mention those who walked before him.
First of all, I want to acknowledge the last two ministers, my good friend and colleague Willie Seal and Barbara Edmonds, and I want to acknowledge the work they did. Yes, we have different political views, but I call them friends and colleagues, so I want to just acknowledge that.
Shane Reti was National's Pacific Affairs spokesperson from 2021. The Māori GP from Northland believes it's that sense of whanaungatanga that gives him confidence in the role, despite the early criticism about some of the government's decisions.
My heart beats for Polynesia. If we want to go all the way back, we're of Polynesian reach, that is me as well. So you say, I understand that we don't have Pacific people in our caucus. That was the cards that democracy gave us. That was where things landed. That aside, I have the absolute privilege of leading this portfolio, and lead it I will.
One of those contentious decisions includes the repeal of Labor's world-leading anti-smoking laws, a move likely to impact Māori and Pasifika the most.
First of all, what I'd say is we're absolutely committed to reducing smoking rates. And I'm encouraged by the ASH survey that came out yesterday, you know, one of our premier NGOs in the smoking domain, indicating that the vaping rates are coming down. And I'm hopeful later this week when other figures come out, we'll continue to see adult smoking coming down.
And while the health portfolio will no doubt keep him busy, Reti says he's already met with community members and officials from the Ministry of Pacific Peoples to map out his priorities for the next 3 years.
When I meet with Pacific people, they say, oh, here's what worries me, here's what matters, housing worries me, you know, all those things. And of course, so it gets merged together in between what an official top-down view looks like and what the view of the people is. And we put that together to define what our outcomes are. I won't preempt them, but I will send the signal that it worries me the high incidence of diabetes, the number of people who have amputations, who are blind because of diabetes, and that huge increasing risk as people get older, particularly if they're Pacifica and Indian, by the way. I already knew it was an issue, now it's a problem. So what do we do about that? What are the interventions? What's already being done? How do I speed them up, or how do I do new things?
The new coalition government has already signalled there will be cuts to the public service across the board, including the Ministry for Pacific Peoples.
As said in the coalition agreement, as an expectation that we would reduce the overall public service. And so, yes, the ministry will be responsible as well. What I'd say is this, judges on our record, and I'm adamant that we'll stand at the end of year one, year two, and year three and say, look at that. That's what we did, judges on that, actually.
In the meantime, the minister says he's looking forward to working with the Pasifika community and plans to spend some of his holidays in the islands.
This is part of the privilege of having the portfolio. I light up, I get that. This is my wider tribe, if you like. And I just get it and love it and feel that companionship and feel that intrinsic warmth. So this Christmas, we'll be enjoying time for the very first time in the Kingdom of Tonga. Really looking forward to that. Yeah, my message would be, enjoy your family, stay safe on the road, stay safe in the water, but enjoy this Christmas moment with your family. They're precious moments.